Good evening. Welcome to the Red Bank Council meeting for February 22nd. Please rise and reflect. Thank you. Roll call, please.
Councilman Youngstrom?
Present.
Councilman Ziprich?
Here.
Councilwoman Horgan?
Here.
Councilwoman Schwappenbauer?
Here.
Councilman Taylor?
Here.
Councilman Whalen?
Here.
We're all here. Sunshine State.
Let the minutes reflect in compliance with Public Law 1975, Chapter 231, Open Public Meetings Act, that notice of this meeting has been provided by notifying the Asbury Park Press, the Chamber of Times, and the Star Ledger by placing notice on the bulletin board and bonding statement to the Borough Clerk on January 11th, 2017.
Thank you. Is there a motion to suspend the regular order of business?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay. We are privileged and pleased to have with us our, some of our youngest residents. I'm not going to say they are the youngest residents, but they are certainly younger than the people sitting on the stage. And we've always celebrated Read Across America. That's always been done at the schools. But at the urging of Council President Horgan, it was thought that we should invite our younger, more intelligent residents than the people on the stage to read to us. So without too much more interference from me, I know that little Miguel is jumping to run up. But Councilwoman, would you like to lead off? Or should I call Luigi up?
I just wanted to say that because some of us couldn't go to speak, to read to the children in school. And do you pronounce your name Zerzurek?
Shurak.
Shurak. I was close. She contacted all of us and asked us if we would come to the school to read to the children because it was Read Across America Week. But some of us work during the day, we can't get there. So I suggested, why not have the kids come and read to us? And so that's why we're here today. And we also have a resolution to celebrate, in celebration of Read Across America Week, that the mayor will read. We'll do it after, we should have the children come first.
The children comes first.
Yes, let's have.
Let them read to us first.
Let's have Luigi come up. Would he like to set the stage, or Ann, or whoever would like to?
Ms. Shurak would love to.
Why not? All right. Come on, will you come with me?
Where should I, over here? Well, good evening.
First of all.
Hook me up. Other chalk, I don't need it. And I was hoping for the kids, children to have it.
Thank you. So good evening, everyone, and thank you for this wonderful opportunity for the students to be here and myself. Do you remember me now?
Yes.
I'm feeling very old because I did have Congressman Mark Taylor. Yes. Excuse me. Now I gave you a promotion.
That must have been a star student, Mark.
But anyway, we're here. I'm here with three students from school. First grader Miguel, raise your hand up, Miguel, from Ms. Doucette's class. There you are. I have Jimena from Mrs. Wall's class, and I have Alex from Mrs. Rivera's class. So we love books, so we're going to share a poem. Each child has a poem about a book. And I'm also here with Donna, who's on the Read Across America Committee, and Miss Vancini. Raise your hand. All right. So do you want to start?
Okay.
Okay, maybe we'll face this way.
When You Can Read by Bobby Katz. When you can read and you can go from Kalamazoo to Idaho, or read directions that explain just how to build a model plane, or bake a cake or cookie stew, the words will tell you what to do. When you can read and you can play a brand new game the proper way, or get a letter from a friend and read it to the very end.
Thank you. Nice job. All right, Miguel? You ready, buddy?
Open a Book by Jane Baskerville. Open a book and you will find people and places of every kind. Open a book and you can be anything that you want to be. Open a book and you can share wondrous world you find in there. Open a book and I will too. Do it to me and I'll read to you.
Great job, Alex. All right, Alex.
Read to me.
Lola.
Jane Yoli. Read to me riddles and read to me rhymes. Read to me stories of magical time. Read to me tales about castles and kings. Read to me stories of fabulous things. Read to me pirates and read to me knights. Read to me dragons and dragon book points. Read to me spaceships and goblins. And then, when you are finished, please read them again.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
You know, don't go away yet.
Okay.
No. By the way, when is the actual Read Across America at the primary school?
We're going to start Monday, February 28th, and it'll go the whole week. It's
right.
Actually March 2nd. Of every year.
Right, that's what I thought, because in the past it runs a number of days, and so I know that this is really great. I'm glad the kids are here, but if you do give us a couple of dates, and it might be possible for some of us. I know I try to go there at least for one of the days, and I know other council members who may not be employed during those particular times. They might want to join us, so we'll be happy to do that.
Oh, we'd love that.
Yeah, so we traditionally done it, so no reason why we shouldn't do it, but I think it's great that you're here with us. And just to watch the wonderful expressions on the faces of some of the families of some of our youngest residents when they were reading, I think they're just precious for us to see how proud the parents and the friends are of these young people for their wonderful accomplishment and what they've done to us. So, they're an inspiration for us. I hope I'm not going to botch the proclamation, because they didn't botch their readings. The proclamation is, whereas reading is the building block to learning and the foundation for future success, and whereas in 1998, the National Education Association celebrated the Read Across America campaign to raise awareness about the importance of reading, and whereas Read Across America is an annual celebration of reading that culminates this year on March 2nd, the day which would have been the 112th birthday of prolific children's author Theodore Seuss Geisel, known and loved worldwide as Dr. Seuss, and whereas Read Across America promotes literacy, readings, and adult involvement in the education of pupils, and to celebrate the joy of reading, pupils, parents, teachers, sports figures, celebrities, firefighters, and business and community leaders, and some politicians, are taking part in Read Across America events throughout the nation. And whereas on March 2nd, 2017, the New Jersey Education Association and the Red Bank Rural Public Schools, along with libraries, bookstores, businesses, and other community organizations, will commemorate the Read Across America Day. Now, therefore, I, Pasquale Mayor of the Borough of Red Bank, hereby proclaim March 2nd, 2017, as Read Across America Day in the Borough of Red Bank, and recommit our community to engage in programs and activities to make America's children the best readers in the world.
Thank you.
You're gonna fight over this? Who's gonna get it? Miguel is the youngest, right?
Yes.
Oh, the youngest. We always go with the youngest. Yeah? Miguel?
You hold it.
Want to hold it?
You all did such a wonderful job. Yeah. Thank you.
Look at my
next. Okay. Do you get in the
picture?
No, you
have
to. Come on.
Yeah.
Lucius,
take the
photo.
We're good. Age before beauty. Age before beauty. One, two.
Thank you.
Just have a little something for each of you. Oh, it's a little kiss. Thank you.
Thank you
so much. I'm sorry, I'll do that more. I should have.
Thank you
so much.
Thank you for
your
time.
You did such a great job. I really appreciate
it. Thank you.
I hope you'll come back to visit us, okay?
Thanks so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And I also want to welcome the Board of Education member that Warner Stories here and our superintendent.
Yes.
And also a board member, Michael. Susan Disconi, because she's always taking her video, so I apologize, child, but not a video. Dr. Rummage, would you like to say anything? Or?
I want to call kids. That's never a good thing to call kids. I'd just like to thank the council once again, specifically Councilman Horgan, for being such a great liaison for our schools and keeping the communication and the relationship and partnership alive, not only as a councilwoman, but also as part of our foundation, the Education Foundation, as many of the council members are a part of. It's been just a great, really amazing time for our school districts and the partnership that we've made with businesses in the community and the council and the foundation has been an outstanding part of our successes. So we thank you for all you've done for us to support our students, our schools, and our staff.
Thank you.
Thank you for all you do, Chair. Thanks. Yes. To all and to all of our teachers.
You're welcome to stay, but we certainly won't hold it against you if you want to take your exit. Okay, I'll resume right in order of business. Second?
Second.
All in favor? Okay, we have a number of things in the workshop. First of all, I'm going to turn it over to Councilman Lindstrom, a brief discussion, an overview of the work of the Parks and Recreation Committee regarding our long range and so far what we've done with respect to the Sunset Avenue Reclamation Center, which will be the Sunset Avenue Park.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Last night we had a meeting open to the public to go over exactly where we are in the process of Sunset Park and how far along it's been, what we've done there, and where we want it to go, or what route we want it to go. Last night was good feedback from most of the public. There's plenty more of opportunities that we're going to have to really engage the public as to what they want in that park and what they want in that area, what features, what type of things they want in that park. So there's going to be plenty more meetings to come. But right now, we've had a proposal from T&M to start it's really going to be the third phase of this. It's the first phase was the demolition phase. The second was the surveying phase to see what contaminants were in the area. And now we need to move forward with a remedial action plan. The remedial action plan is going to take into consideration what could possibly be there down the road, what activities, what source of park we're going to have. The remedial action plan is the third step. We're ready to go. We're ready to move forward in getting a park to the west side that's going to be inclusive of everybody on the west side, including the town. Everybody in the town is going to be really able to come and enjoy this park. So I think right now I would like to make a motion to add this to the agenda, the regular agenda, so we can move forward with this project and get this really, get the ball rolling so we can get Sunset Park underway.
Okay. Thank you for the brief overview, and I think that, well, nobody on this side, and I think that obviously you were not on the council. Ed and Kathy were initially on the council for some of the work. So this has been, as Eric indicated, a multi-phase project that the borough has quietly and very aggressively, in another sense, been engaged in for the greater part now of about 7 years. So we committed some time ago to reclaim the property. This has been our municipal reclamation center. As some of the residents will recall, as I can recall, there were even more incinerator stacks that we used to use quite actively as a municipality before they were banned by the state. So the site itself is, I believe, about 6 acres. It is impacted by extraordinary fluid vegetation, all types, a lot of flora and fauna. But a lot of it has been unfortunately impacted by the use of the property for many decades, almost 100 years. So the first step, as Eric said, is for the borough to roll up its sleeves, go to the state, which we did. We've secured state funding, 100% state funding, to clean up the site. So phase one was, as Eric indicated, we had to remove a lot of the structures, which were structures that could not be on the property, smokestacks and the rest. The cleanup and the capping. So that's basically what we've been doing. A lot of people have been saying, well, why don't you move ahead with it? And the answer to that is we have been moving ahead with it, but as anyone that is familiar with anything that DEP is engaged in, they want to make sure that if it's going to be open to the public, that it has to be done under very strict regulations. And it is time consuming, and there's an element of time that has to pass by the time that you start capping and cleaning the site and taking environmental samples, which have to be on a very regular basis. So it's been taking a long time. That doesn't mean it's been abandoned. It doesn't mean we've been dormant. It's just that on these environmental sites, they do take time. Reaching the end of that phase now, fortunately, to the satisfaction of DEP. The other great news for all of our residents is that has been the costs, which are extraordinary, have been borne by the state. So we're very fortunate that we were able to do that. What Eric is suggesting and what his committee is now moving forward is that in the next few weeks and months ahead, there will be public notices in terms of trying to get community input, trying to get organizational input as to a vision. And we will certainly need the assistance of our technical staff. But more importantly, the clarion call is to go out to the community and try to get a dialogue and feedback, because we are committed and the funding is there. It's just that we have to be somewhat patient, and I think that we have been, and our residents have been patient, but we're completely committed. So, Eric, I want to thank you, and I want to thank your committee for moving forward with the project. And I know we're going to be looking forward to a schedule of when public comments will be submitted.
Mr. Mayor, may I comment?
Sure.
The only thing I'd like to clarify, and I think you touched on this, but I want to make sure that people will hear it, is that when we were chairing this committee of priorities, residents would say to us, why aren't you moving ahead with that? And the choice that we made was, we can move slowly, or we can pay for it ourselves. We paid for it ourselves. It cost hundreds of thousands of dollars, and it would have moved faster. But we've chosen to save the money and move at a much slower pace. And so that's where we're at today. And Eric, thank you for picking up the ball and moving it forward. And I'm voting for the dog park. So we can subtly get that in
there. Thank you, Linda. And I completely share your sentiments. But I guess my only comment would be that even assuming we had taken charge and we had done the actual work ourselves, I'm not necessarily sure that we would have been able to reach the decisions faster, because we still would have needed the NFA letters as well as the clearance letters from the state, which will be coming, but they still haven't done. So the timetable is really driven by the state, but I appreciate your assistance.
Anybody else? Mayor, but just might add, when I first came on this council, we voted to take the incinerator down, and that has been a long and slow process, and as Councilwoman Schwabenbauer pointed out, we have been funded by the state. This is a very, very positive step for the borough that we have been working on for a good many years now, and we have taken the opportunity to work very closely with the engineers, both locally and on the state level, and the DEP, you know, to make sure that what we're doing is environmentally sound. So I look forward to getting this project further underway.
Okay. Anyone else? Okay. I think there is a resolution that permits us to move forward, and without objection, I'll add it to the end. And just for purposes of the public, because you know, I think the public ought to know that this phase of what we're moving on, that Eric has indicated, will be done by our former engineer, who has been engaged in this particular project since day one. So it makes sense to continue with that. And we do have an estimate, which has been reviewed by the CFO in terms of availability of funding and also consistency with the grant that we got from the state. And it would be, if we move forward, which I think we will, an allocation of $47,000 to continue the actual next phase. Okay. So I'll add it on at the end of the meeting. Second item is the for workshop is the property maintenance ordinance, and I know that we had introduced it. There were some questions and concerns, and as a result of that, the property maintenance order has been ordinance has been tweaked. And again, the emphasis on this is on the maintenance and moving forward of essentially stalled projects and stalled properties, some of which have received approvals, and having a licensing formula for them. Our concern was that it did not impact single family homeowners because of family issues and the like, and I'm happy to report that the revised ordinance does address that in a very favorable fashion, and that single family homeowners would still be required to register. The first year would be at no fee, the second year would be at the nominal of $50, the third year, so on. So it does address those issues.
Mr. Mayor, yeah. I just want to let you know, we met again last night as a committee on this particular ordinance. There was some other language we wanted to address, so there are additional tweaks. We're not going to move it tonight. We give it to Greg to Mr. Gannon to get that language in there. We'll have to make some additional review, but I wanted to make sure the entire council had an opportunity to review it before we put it on.
It's fine with me.
Okay.
Okay, so it's off. Nothing else for workshop? I'll just take off. Approval of the minutes for February 8th motion?
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
No appointments?
I wasn't here.
Okay. Reports of mayor and council members, and again, this is now subject to these limits that we've imposed on ourselves. Councilwoman Trautenberg.
No report, Mr. Mayor.
That's a good limit. Councilman Taylor.
First to go forward, I just kind of summed up what we talked about in COVID. So.
Thank you, Councilor.
Thank you, Mayor. Just briefly, on this weekend, we got to celebrate the retirement party of Captain Thomas McDonough, who served 31 years for the Red Bank Police Department. It was a great ceremony. Almost the entire police force came out to honor him at Buenos Aires. I was able to present the proclamation on behalf of the mayor, so I appreciate that. And we got to meet his family. It's a beautiful family, an extraordinary man, and an unbelievable career. So it was definitely a great weekend. I want to thank the councilwoman, she did come, and other obligations. And this weekend is the Fire Department Awards, where we honor the new chief, the ex-chief, and other departments for citations and throughout the year. So it's going to be a good weekend for the police and fire. That's all.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yes.
Kathy?
No.
Thank you. Ed?
Well, just quickly, the DPW committee met this afternoon. We covered facilities, parks, water and sewer, some signage issues. We discussed the weather event and the cleanup and how well the entire team did during that snowstorm, which I thank our director for. And then we covered some capital projects, and that's pretty much it.
Thank you.
Eric? Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I just want to let everybody know to please mark their calendars for the second annual Cinco de Mayo celebration. It'll take place Friday evening, May 5th. We'll feature dance, poetry, and musical performances by Red Bank students from all three schools, tentatively scheduled at the primary school. That still may change, so we'll put that up on the website. Sign-ups are underway for the Red Bank Community Garden. Season will begin March 4th. The cost is $25 per season. And registration forms are available in Parks and Rec. Please contact either the Rec Department or Cindy Burnham with any questions. Boat slips are also available in the marina now. And then lastly, the Parks and Rec is going to host a West Side Town Hall meeting at St. Anthony's of Padua Church on March 9th from 7 to 8:30. The goal is to improve communication and listen to suggestions on what residents want. So last year's meeting was very productive, and we're scheduling a similar event this year.
Thank you. Just one quick item. Thank you all for your keeping it all concise. I had already announced that I'm asking our CFO to provide a report to the council on our allocation of deposits in the borough of Red Bank. There is a trend that is developing in some of the smarter cities of the state. And I mean, for example, even Jersey City led the trend and they just finally completed the program. All municipalities hold extraordinary amounts of monies in banks. And I don't know how it's spread out. However, in Jersey City's example, something like 80% of all deposits were in multinational Wall Street corporation funds, banks, and only a small amount, 10-15%, was in local organic banks that were small in Hudson County or the community. So Mayor Fuller, fortunately, a smart guy, reversed the trend, and right now in Jersey City, and this is happening in all other cities, local organic small-driven banks, community banks, are now the holders, at least in Jersey City, roughly 85% of all funds, which are municipal funds, which are public funds. And the rest is by the larger banking institutions. Now, we have a lot of banks and banking institutions in Red Bank. I really don't know how much is held in each one of them, but I'm going to ask our CFO to do a computation of the funds and percentages that are allocated in those particular banks around to see whether it would be my preference to shift the majority of those deposits to local banks, which I think are more responsive to the needs of average people in our community and have been started by people and institutions in our community instead of the large hedge funds starting, you know, multinational banks that HSBC and the rest that have no connection to our community. So I await that report and then we'll talk about it some more, but I think it's a great trend for us to do, and we really should start thinking about that, and maybe other initiatives from that report is starting to do. I remember when I first came out of council, there was a dictate from favorable governments that local banks had to loan a certain percentage of funds to local communities as reinvestment funds in those communities. I frankly don't know what the status of that project or those laws are, but I think this is one way to start looking at those because we do have the needs both. Okay. There are no appointments this evening, communications and petitions. The following have been approved by special events, request to hold cattle and advocacy day on September 17th at Maple Cove. Request from Red Bank River Center to hold the following events: the Wedding Walk on March 26th, Farmers Market from May 21 through November 19th, Streetlight performances in June, July, and August, and the 6th Annual International Beer, Wine, and Food Fest on April 30th, Sidewalk Sale on July 28th through July 30th, 8th Annual Red Bank Guinness Oyster Festival on September 24th. Girls Night Out on October 19, 2017. I think that should probably be Girls and Boys Night Out. Let's be inclusive here. But in any event, we might have to come up with a Boys Night Out. Yeah, but oh, you don't want to be with the boys, okay, whatever. I thought I was being liberal. The 24th Holiday Express Concert on November 24th, and the Holiday Horse and Carriage Rides on November 25 through December 23. And Holiday Harmonies between November 25th and December 23rd. Before we act on it, I know Mr. Scavone is here, he's always very diligent and does extraordinary amount of work, and he's also a smart guy. I know that years ago I raised the question with respect to the horse and buggy rides. I know I have sympathy for horses, but in any event, I was overridden on that. I have no problem with the horse and buggy rides. No, so I'm not raising that issue again. However, I would hopefully ask you to meet with traffic safety, and my only concern, and is that the horse and buggy rides, normally the route that they take is from the Galleria down Front Street. Front Street is one of our most congested, rubbernecking arteries in town, other than Lincoln Avenue at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. My only request is if River Center can calculate a better route, still do the horse and buggy rides, maybe take it down Mammoth Street, maybe take it down some of the other side streets. Still go on Broad Street. The problem is not the Broad Street. The problem is Front Street, because especially if, when people come off that parkway, and you're really holding up a lot of traffic, and that's the only suggestion I have. So with that in mind, you know, I'll leave it to yourself. But I'm sure you've heard some of the same issues on sure. the traffic back then.
Yeah, we have no problem with that.
Okay. So motion.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Request from Felipe Hernandez for membership in the first in the fire police unit of the Riverside Volunteer Fire Department. Michael?
So moved.
Second.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
We are tabling ordinance 2017-06. Is there a motion to table?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Are there any members of the public who have any comments on any of our resolutions? There's only a few prior to taking action. Okay, motion to close.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Resolution 1744, authorizing the appointment of regular crossing guards for 2016-17, pursuant to the recommendation of the chief. Motion.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Yeah. I was choked up by that. Resolution 1745, authorizing change order number 2 related to the contract to Precise for the Green Park site bottom and place modification.
Motion. So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
We have 1746, which is a resolution.
Council President.
I need some more.
Resolution 1746, which is a resolution authorizing T&M Associates to provide preliminary concept plan for Sunset Avenue Park. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed?
Any opposed? Okay.
Okay, we have one proclamation this evening.
World Spray Day.
Proclamation of World Spay Day. Whereas World Spay Day started out as Spay Day USA, an annual event created by the Doris Day Animal League in 1995 to promote spays and neuters across the country to help eliminate the problem of homeless pets. And whereas after the Doris Day Animal League's merger with the Humane Society of the United States in 2006, the tradition continued under the auspices of the Humane Society of the United States as World Spay Day. And whereas critical lack of resources and public awareness are key factors that contribute to pet overpopulation, according to the Humane Society of the United States, and many more animals are abandoned as there are simply not enough homes for all of them. And whereas one unspayed female cat and her unaltered offspring can produce, this is mind-boggling, 420,000 cats in 7 years. So it is easy to see how spaying and neutering can dramatically reduce the number of unwanted animals that are euthanized in animal shelters. And whereas spaying and neutering can help protect against health and behavioral problems associated with the mating instinct, and spaying of female dogs and cats and neutering of male pets can help protect them from serious health problems later in life. Now therefore, I, Pascual Mena, Mayor of the Borough of Red Bank, do hereby proclaim February 28th, 2017, to be Spay Day in the Borough of Red Bank, and urge all residents to have their pets spayed or neutered to help reduce pet overpopulation and to reduce the need for unwanted animals to face euthanasia, and encourage them to contact the SPCA or the Humane Society to obtain information on low-cost spay and neuter programs.
Thank you. We also have Resolution 1747. Be it resolved by the Mayor and Council, the bills be paid on the following registry total: $5,551,251.84. Linda?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? No. Any old business? Any new business?
Just one quick item, Mayor. The Red Bank Borough Education Foundation will be holding their 50-50 raffle. Tickets will be on sale if they're not already. But that is forthcoming, and the raffle will be held on April 28th at International Day at the primary school.
Thank you. Audience, any members of the audience wish to address the council in support?
Hello, 16 Locust Avenue, Ben Forrest, speaking for myself. Pat Park, I couldn't make it last night, but I'm so glad to hear that you're having a meeting about it and the report tonight, and that you're seeking input. I guess Amy and I moved here in 96, and there was talk of it even back then, about doing a park back there, and it does seem extraordinarily slow, even by environmental. Department of Environmental Protection standards, and anything that can be done to speed it up, of course, would be appreciated. It has been a big problem on the west side that there is no park, and we raised our kids now without one there, really. We would go to Count Basie Park, thank heavens that's there, but it's a very busy, I wouldn't want to say overused park. And there's, you know, there's stuff there that you really can't use unless, you know, you're part of an organized program. It's a nice playground, but we really desperately need a park on the west side, and it's been a really big deficiency for at least the 20 years I've lived here. I'm sure it goes way before back then. It's not an ideal location, it's not as central as I would like it to be, but I'll take it. It's also led to kind of some, I don't think, thoroughly thought out thinking, like, for example, putting the water feature park, I don't know what we wound up calling it, the name changed over a period of time, like at the bottom of my street on Locust Avenue, and there was a great lack of enthusiasm on Locust Avenue for the idea because there's absolutely no parking. We already have a parking problem down there, and I don't know, I guess people who walk to it would get some use of it, but it also floods there on a regular basis, and it's actually, I like having a passive park there personally. I know everybody has their own opinions, but I don't think it was a really good idea for a water feature location myself, but it has, you know, because of the desperation of having a park on the west side, I think was a big reason that we were thinking kind of, well, maybe we could put it there. And we have a governor's race coming up. You know, things are going to change probably in Jersey a little bit. I think maybe, perhaps, when, you know, whoever is running for office comes to town, maybe our advocate here, maybe you can push them for some money or something to speed up the process of having a park on the west side, because the town really needs one. It's not really fair to the residents on the west side. We have a lot of kids. And I don't like crossing Shrewsbury Avenue as a grown-up, so we need something. Glad we're working forward, but it's been overdue and it's taken too long, and I know it's not your fault. It takes a lot. There's a lot of things going on there. The park has to be safe and toxic-free. But it really is something that needs to be addressed and as quickly as possible.
Thank you. Anybody else?
Barbara Boas, 135 Branch Avenue. Just a public service announcement. I'm pleased to announce that the Red Bank Mayor's Ball will be Pat's living. It's a lot of work, Pat.
I know. I think about Arthur Murray dance students now that they're in town.
Well, yeah, you know, maybe they'll come over and teach us all how to dance. It's going to be May 5th at the Oyster Point, and we're going to be honoring four very, very, very good people and organizations here in Red Bank, and we're going to be presenting our finances to St. Anthony's every time I read it, it's a different name, but it's St. Anthony's Social Concerns Outreach Program and the Monmouth Daycare. So there are the recipients of the fund, and our honorees are going to be Reverend Porter for a humanitarian award, the Food Town for industry, the Police Department for historic legacy, and Roger Mumford for urban design and development. So hope you will all put that on your calendar now. And I think it's going to be a good event, as usual. And we're going to have the same band as we had last year, guys. So that was good. All right. Thank you.
Thanks, Barbara. Thank you, Barbara.
Thanks, Barbara. I'll manage a public service announcement. Encourage everybody to buy tickets early because it sold out rapidly last year.
Oh, yeah. All the years. The invitations will be going out next week.
Yes, sir.
But I am collecting.
Yes, now. And gifts.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. I've met most of you, but two I have not on various occasions.
Excuse me, just on record.
I'm Bill Kastning, Monmouth Conservation Foundation.
That's what I thought. I just give the address for Monmouth Conservation.
Monmouth Conservation Foundation, we go by our P.O. Box address.
Yes,
P.O. Box 4150, Middletown, New Jersey. But we're located in the Sunnyside Recreation Area in Middletown. My organization, that I'm the executive director of, we've been around for 40 years. I've been here for 5 now. We discussed other things in the past, but I've had the opportunity to meet 4 of the council people here in the last couple of weeks regarding Sunset Park. My organization is willing to support this effort in many ways, one of which is to facilitate getting funding for it, so we've done this once before in Asbury Park. We assisted the city there in getting the funding it needed to complete what is known as Springwood Avenue Park on its west side, and we've had a lot of experience, and that was a successful endeavor. That park opened this past summer, and the residents love it. It was an underserved area. I think absolutely you need the park here on your west side. And just so you know, we facilitated the acquisition of Chris's Marina, which is now being called Swimming River Park. And we're facilitating the acquisition of the deli to add to the park. The deli has seen better days, so it will not be there as a deli. It will be more open space. And that site is also very much encumbered by environmental issues. And with some of the individuals last night, I talked about what is happening there. And they are also, Middletown is, or the county is actually getting a lot of free money from the state through the HDSRF funding. So we discussed this last night, but I also, in addition to the funding, we would like to offer our services to facilitate the community involvement, especially maybe March 9th at the church, to assist with the gaining the input that is so necessary by the residents who desperately want this park, and they have a lot of good ideas. And many times, if an independent party facilitates something, maybe you'll get better input than if the borough did it or the borough engineers did it. So I offer that service as well. But thank you for this opportunity. Appreciate it.
Bill, first of all, thank you for being here and thank you for your kind words. And obviously I know firsthand a lot of the great work that the Monmouth Conservation Foundation has been doing for so many years. Your offer is warmly accepted. What I have to say is that one of the reasons I'm so enthusiastic about Sunset Avenue and what will develop at Sunset Avenue Park is that it is directly across from the future Swimming River. And I think it's a natural symbiotic relationship between the two parks across the creek from each other. And I really think that it's going to do wonders for both the residents of Middletown and the residents of Burbank to have that closeness within earshot of each other. And I thank you for your offer, and certainly we'll be talking.
Very good. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Thanks very much, Phil.
Anybody else? Reverend Porter.
Good evening, Mayor.
Good evening.
Terrence Porter, Reverend Terrence Porter, pastor of the Pilgrim Baptist Church in Red Bank, also the president of the Red Bank Affordable Housing Corporation. Mayor, we are here, I am here to represent the Red Bank Affordable Housing Corporation in support of the Sunset Park Initiative. We know that it has a lot of phases to go, but we are really excited about the Red Bank Affordable Housing Corporation being involved with the wellness of this particular project because it affects our community. To that end, the Red Bank Affordable Housing Corporation has agreed to the board meeting to support the initiative and also to work with our resources through the state of New Jersey to help finance portions of this particular initiative. It's important to us because we focus on affordable housing, but we also have broadened our mission statement to include community wellness projects in 2010. And this, the Sunset Park, comes under that umbrella. So to that end, we want to do what we could do because this park affects the West Side, but it affects the quality of living in all of Red Bank. I think it opens up space for usage with the recreation department. It allows families to go to a nice, safe place without crossing over Shrewsbury Avenue. And it just affords the community another positive feature that would draw residents and homeowners into the Red Bank community. So we are in support, and the council has our support to do whatever we can in financing the effort that's going to be needed to finance the park. So thank you, and God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor.
Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Porter. And you know, the reason why we keep on saying we're so enthusiastic about this, I remember as a kid growing up in Red Bank, all of the waterfront access was always on the east side. And residents of the west side did not have waterfront access of any type. This will permit that waterfront access for residents of the west side, which they're entitled to, just like residents of the east side. So I think it's just a wonderful fit. And can't wait to move forward. Anybody else? Ms. Byrne.
Cindy Byrne, I'm 71 Wallace. So Mayor, I wasn't even gonna speak tonight until you said people on the east side have access to the river. Where?
Marine Park.
Okay.
Riverside Gardens Park, Maple Cove.
Well, wait a minute. That doesn't, you can't get to the river from Riverside. You can look at the river.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean.
Okay, I thought you meant like to get down to the river and get out on the water.
No, I meant okay. At least have a visual of it. You know?
Okay, because people on the east side, I mean, you know, when we sold our public boat ramp to Riverview, that was an access to the water at the foot of Washington. You could get to the water. What?
Very steep.
It was a public access. People used it, I'm just saying. But I just wonder what you had in mind when you said people on the east side have access to the
enjoy
river.
At least a bucolic view of the river.
Right. And you know, now that I'm up here, I'm just going to ask this question. At the last meeting regarding Sunset, you folks had voted 68,000 for Sunset, wasn't it?
No.
What was that for? 60-something.
We didn't vote anything on Sunset.
All right, I don't have my paperwork in front of me, so that's why I wasn't going to ask. But this 48,000 that you're talking about now,
yes.
Is that from the state?
Yeah, that's correct. It's part of the original grant.
You reimbursed from the state.
Okay, and is this a matching grant?
No,
it's a straight up, they're giving it to us.
They've been paying the whole cost of the cleanup and the remediation. And the site work, yes, and this is part of that.
And do they pay for the T&M costs, or that comes out of Red Bank?
What T&M costs?
The engineering costs.
No, this 47,000 comes out with the funding. In other words, yes. We will advance it, they will reimburse us, so it does come from the state.
Oh, good. Okay, thank you.
It's a good program.
Sounds it.
Wish we could get more of it. Anybody else? Okay. Seeing no further public comment. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Boynton.
Good afternoon, Mayor. E65 Street family. Mr. Mayor, I got here a little late, but got a little brief on this park. I just want to know the park on West Bergen, the daycare center, can the kids still play in that area right now? Where it was terminated on West Bergen, Dr. Park Boulevard. Can they still play in that area right there before you go on the...
No. The playground equipment was removed. There was a cap put on it, but it can't be used until it's sealed, until we have to do something. Right now it's going to be for grass, and they did a 3-foot cap on top of what was some contamination that was found underneath that. The Board of Education owns that property.
I'm just saying, is it fixed yet?
It's capped, and they're growing grass there. So they did remove the top layers down, I believe it was 3 feet, probably 24 inches and 3 feet. And they put the cap on there, and right now they're working the grass to take it back.
Because you know, Mr. Mayor, and I grew up here, 128 West Westside Avenue, right by the dump. So I know my father used to work at the incinerator place there. I know what's down there. So I just want to make sure when y'all go through with this, all of that stuff going to be taken out, because if it don't have so,
that's
serves it's the purpose.
So long. Yeah.
It's going to serve the purpose in years to come, and we're going to have a problem with the kids. So I just want to make sure. You can't go so deep because there's water there. You can't go so deep. And you know, if you're going to do the whole thing, just make sure it's right. We need to have the architect, somebody come to explain what they're going to put on and show somebody what they're going to put on top of this stuff. Because it is terminated down there. You got signs down there now. Terminated. No fishing, no crabbing. They down there now. And we want to make sure that when you fix this pump, that sub pump right there by Montgomery Terrace, that new one you put there, a couple summers ago, it overflowed and it ran into the river. So y'all had to come down there, get 10 falls to come over here. I remember late at night with the trucks and suck that. So we want to make sure all of these things are going to be correct before you do that, because you're only going to make it worse years to come.
And in summary, Fred, that sump pump overflowed because it needed to be replaced. We replaced it. We have a backup generator on it. One of the things was it was a power thing. So we have a backup generator. It's gas fed. They'll all be placed, and we have alarms on them. So when it fails, we get an alarm right away that we can respond.
I understand. You're talking about the one in the middle.
And, right, well, that was moved. That's now at the end of Dr. Park.
I'm talking about the new one, where the fence then, that overflowed. It overflowed. It backed up, and the water was running everywhere. And I know 10 Falls had to come here late at night, because I think they had to use their truck or whatnot. There's a guy from 10 Falls, and he was in Red Bank late at night working on that pump. But I'm just saying, all these things that y'all have to look into, make sure.
That's what this whole...
You know, man, because I don't think...
The step we're taking is to address those concerns and come up with a plan for that final solution to that part. That's what the council authorized here.
I'm concerned, and like I said, I like to see a park over there, but I know what's down there. I lived there all these years. All these gas stations in Red Bank, that's where they used to take all their tires, motor oil and everything. Air conditions, all that. I know what's down there. I'm just saying, all this stuff got to be placed. Nobody on this bench can sit here and say they know the feeling what a child go through in life if they end up ill. I lost 2 kids. My son was 8 months old when he got sick. And he passed when he was 2 years old. He was a vegetable. The things that I had to go through, to see this baby laying in the hospital, couldn't speak, couldn't talk, couldn't even ask what was wrong, just cry out. Going in and out of season, it's a terrible thing. Then I lost a daughter a couple of years ago for a kidney failure. So I'm just saying, y'all don't know the experience to see a baby in the hospital for any sickness or illness. So I think a lot of things we need to look into putting this down there. Just jump it up doing it, but you need to go down there and really dig. Like I told you yesterday, Stanley, New Jersey, Newark. I deliver steel to them places. They're doing the same thing what y'all doing here. When I have my tractor trailer, steel to them places. and they put it all around the bulkhead. And the guy said, years to come, it comes back up to the surface. Because the pressure that you put on top, it pushes down and it's gonna come up. So I just wanna say, make sure we do this right.
Thank you, Fred. Anyone else? Okay, do we have need for, I think we have need for a brief executive session. So we will be retiring to executive session to discuss personnel and litigation. However, no official action will be taken. We will just be coming back out to adjourn formally at that time, but no action will be taken. So I want to thank everyone for coming, and have a pleasurable evening. Motion to adjourn.